Actually, this is my Edit Plus software. Okay, so I will tell you how to configure, or you can install, you can practice on any IDE. Saurabh, mute it, okay? This voice is, you know, breaking, not muted in your side. You know, Java. So, this is my Edit Plus software, so I will tell you later.
So, this will not.
Oh, okay.
Yeah.
So, when you are starting any Java file, so we have a class key, right? So, class key work and demo test. So, after that, what we are going to do? So, your Java code is starting from here. So, what happened? If you are creating any class, then we have to save this class as a dot Java file. Okay. Okay, just check once. You don't have a laptop?
Yeah.
Use from laptop. You join any small company, so you have to do the setup from the starting for Selenium. So in your system, you should have a JDK. Okay, so how to install the JDK? Just download the JDK and install it. After installing the JDK, if you will go inside this program files, we have a Java. So you can see these two folders. So new Java is not, JR is there, so follow this 1.8 version, okay? So first in your system, JDK is there. I'm using this Edit Plus software, so I will tell you how to configure in the coming classes, but whatever the software you are using, that is fine, okay? Your practice purpose. So how to start the Java coding? First, we have this, okay? JDK is there in your system. You can use any software to practice for the Java. This is the Edit Plus, so I will tell you how to configure tomorrow, okay? So today, just we'll see, then what happened? If you are starting Java project, then we will save the file in the .java extension, right? So, I'm saving this file in, this is your class, this is class keyword and this is your class name. So first what you have to do, you have to save this file in what is the file name? So won't copy it. So first we'll copy this and save this file in .java extension is there. So I saved this. Okay, so what happened here, we are using this class keyword. Okay, so why we are using this class keyword? Okay, so in Java we have a 53 keyword and 48 keyword which is using, okay? So now, what is the use of this class keyword? So if you will go here, so what happened? The use of this class keyword is real world object. You know, if you, you know, Java is object oriented programming language. So what do you meaning of real world object? Real world object means everything is an object here, right? So if I will compare with real time example, so what we are doing, these are the real world object, right? Anything like same computer, bank, employer, railway, flight, cab, mobile. So what happened, these objects are there, but how to present in the programming world, right? Programming world, what do you meaning of programming world? Programming world means this is, you know, programming world. So these are the real world object. You can see if you are going for the any website, we have a net banking, right? We have a e-commerce, a Redbus, IRCT, all are real world object. we are going to convert into the programming world. What is the meaning of programming world? Programming world means we are doing the automation, right? Before, e-commerce was not there. Then we are going to, you know, shop and going to buy this product, right? So what happened? It will take more time, right? Timing issue and many problems are there for offline, you know, buying the your product and all. But online means what happened? We have automated, right? So simply way you can buy the product and you can, you know, do, you know, from your home. So it is sorted out. You're saving the time. Productivity is more, right? So these are, you know, real world object. If you want to present, then how to present in the coding? How to present in the coding? So this real world object, you know, this real world object we are converting into the programming world. Means your application is starting from, you know, while developing the application, but all object, these are object, how to convert, you know, in programming world. Means if you are going to start to develop the code, then this all real world object, how to present in the Java in programming. So we will, that's why we are using this class keyword. Okay, so object oriented programming language, I will explain all the things. Okay, so now I explained here what the meaning of class keyword. So class is a keyword. We have a 53 keyword in the Java, and three we are not using, means 58 keyword we were using. Okay, coming session we will discuss. This is the also class is a keyword, that class keyword as a class level of the keyword. Okay, so why we are using this class keyword? If you have any real world object but representing in the programming world, then that's why we are going to use this class keyword. If you will go in the Google, many things is there regarding the class, but real time, you know, why we are representing this. And apart from this, you can see this is the blueprint of an object. So this is the word, okay, blueprint of an object, but actually why we are using. So when you are going to start this, you know, class keyword with class name, then in Java we have a opening and curly braces, right? So this opening and curly braces, this field is called your class field. Okay, this field is called your class keyword. Now how to start this coding inside this field? If I will write here system dot out dot println, if you will write system dot out dot println, okay, now I save this file. Okay, after saving this file, we have a compiler. Okay, so what is the job of compiler? Actually, Java did not execute your code directly. We have to compile. So when you are installing JDK, then by default this software is already in your system. So JDK I have installed in my system. We have a compiler, we have a JRE, and we have a JVM. So this is, this three things is the inbuilt inside this JDK. Okay, so when you are installing the JDK, these three things are there in your system. So when you are going to execute your code, then before execution we have some, you know, compiler is there, then JVM is there, then JR is there. So all the things, what is the use of this, all the software we'll discuss. So after developing the code, this code is called source code. Okay, hi. Okay, so this code is called source code. Source code means just developer have developed the code. They did not compile, they did not execute. I did not compile this code. What is the meaning of compiler? Okay, you can see this. So in my system, I configure this. So if I will press Control 1, it will compile. So what is the job of compiler? Compiler will check the syntax of the code. Okay, but you can see I am getting this error, line number 5, illegal start of type. Okay, so compiler is throwing this error. What is the job of compiler? Compiler is checking the syntax of the Java, which is applicable for the Java concept. If it is not applicable for the Java concept, then compiler will throw error. Okay, so what is the job of compiler? Compiler will check the syntax, which is applicable for the Java. The concept must be followed for the Java. If it is not following, yeah, some problem is there, you know, compiler will throw error. Okay, so you can see we have a problem. You know, I have created a class keyword, but the problem is, you can see a illegal startup type. So we are in the second steps, compiler. So compiler is not able to compile this code. We are getting this error, but we will understand why this error is coming. So just I am commenting this. Okay, I will come. This field is called class field. If you will compile here, you know, I am able to compile this. Okay, there is no error. After, if you will compile this code, then what happened internally? One dot class file will be generated. Okay, so what is, what do you meaning of dot class file? I'll show you in my system. This is demo Java. Okay, so we have a demo Java folder here. Where it is? Okay, I'll show you here. Okay. You can see this is called your dot Java file. Okay. After compilation, what happened? The compiler will generate this dot Java class file. What is meaning of dot Java class file? Dot Java. This is the bytecode. Okay. The JVM is not able to understand our language. Whatever I have written, JVM, Java Virtual Machine, is not able to understand. So that's why, you know, after compilation, one file will be generated that is called dot class file. This dot class file, JVM will understand. Okay. Now we have to interact with the JVM, then we are getting this output. So how this complete Java class is, you know, how when you are starting Java software or starting the Java coding, then how it is going to work internally. First you have a JDK, then after that you have a one editor. So I am using edit plus editor. Then after that going to start the Java coding, then we have a class keyword, then class name. So class keyword means real world object converted into the programming world. What is the real world object? Your class name is your real world object. Then this part we have completed. Compiler is done, compilation is done, then dot class file is also generated. Now we have to interact with the JVM, Java Virtual Machine, then we'll get output. Okay, so now if you will compile this, I am able to compile, but if you will, you know, execute this in my system, I have a configured this edit plus software. So if I will control 2, you can see, you know, we are not able to interact with JVM. Second steps. Okay, main method not found in Java class. Please define the main method. Okay, so here the concept is coming method. Okay, so here main method. So main method will come later, but why this is, you know, asking this, why main method is required when you are developing your Java coding, and if main method is not there, then what will happen? So all the concept will come from your method concept. Okay, so now we have this. So what happened? As a class level, one question is there. If you have any Java code, main method is not there, can we compile or not? Yes, we can compile, but we cannot execute. Okay, so first we have to understand method concept, then I will come back with your main method. Before I was writing this code, okay, hi, okay, so what is the system dot 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 println? So system is a class, inbuilt class developed by the Java, out is a variable and println is a method. This is the logic they have already developed. We are using this logic, okay. The system is a class, out is a variable and println is a method. So by using this print statement, you know, we are going to print. Someone will ask, what is this system dot out dot println? System is a class, out is a variable and println is a method. This is the inbuilt statement developed by the Java people. When now I will compile this, you know, we are getting this error. One more conclusion we will get here. As a class level, this is called your class field. As a class level, we cannot write any logic, because this is the logic, right? System dot out dot println. This logic is developed by the Java people. Already they have developed. So as a class level, we cannot write the logic directly. Okay. So how to write the logic directly? Okay. So Java, what is the meaning of logic? Okay. So there are two types of the logic. One is your business logic and one is your mathematical logic. What is the meaning of business logic? You know, how this net banking is working, how this, you know, application is working. So these are the business logic. E-commerce application, how it is working, you know, all are the logic they have developed to, you know, for business purpose. And if you are performing some mathematical operation, that is called mathematical logic. Okay, so what is the conclusion? Here, as a class level, we cannot write logic directly. So how to write the logic? So Java people have developed the concept called method. Okay, so later I will tell you, you know, method concept in deeply, but here I am creating one method. So you should not understand how I am creating this method, just you will understand. This is called user defined method. This is called user defined method. Okay, so I will come on this. This is called your user defined method. Okay, so now what is the meaning of user defined method? The method which is created by us, that is called user defined method. Okay, so when you are developing any logic or any, you know, logic, so logic we cannot write as a class level. Logic we will write inside this method. So what is the meaning of a static void and all, we will discuss later. Okay, we have a method having a separate topic. So here just we are just, you understood, this is the method and this is called user defined method. If I will compile now, you know, we are getting this here, you know, I'm not able to get any error. But before I was creating this logic as a class level, I was getting the error, right? So this error, one second. Okay, so now actually, okay, you got some idea about a method, why we are using the method, right? So method, if you have any logic, you cannot write a logic as a class level. Class level we can write, we have to create a method. Without method we cannot write the logic. So before I was getting this error as a compile time. Now if I will compile this, I'm not getting any error. Okay, so you got some idea about of this, why main method is required. So we have a method user defined and I will come on this main method. Okay, so now if I will compile this, now we were not getting error, but this is completed now. Before I was getting the error, but now again we'll create it. Now if I will execute this code, But still, JBM is asking, where is your main method? Main method is not found in a class demo. Please define the main method. Actually, what happened? We are the user and we are the developer, right? So Java people have developed one method that is called main method, which is common for all users. Your question is, we have a user defined method, but why we need, you know, main method? This is the question. Why we need a main method? Might be I am developer, might be other developer is there. If, you know, they will create own method. Just I have created a static method. If someone will create non-static method, someone will create return type method, void method, okay? So what happened? This JVM will confuse, right? If you are creating different method, then how to interact with the JVM? Because JVM is not able to understand us, right? So every users or every developer will create, might be they will create a different method, right? They will create different method. So what happened? How to interact with the JVM? JVM is not able to recognize all types of the method. Okay, so what happened? The JVM developer who developed this JVM, they have created one common method that is called main method. Okay, why, you know, so this method logic, main method logic is already developed. Okay, when you install the JDK and JVM, this already main method is already inbuilt, developed. The JVM people have developed the common method. That method is common for all. Okay, so now what happens if they have developed the logic? If you will execute anything, if I have compiled here, okay, now I am able to compile. If you will execute your code, then it will search the main method, if main method is there or not. When you can see here is finding your main method when you are executing this, but main method is not found, then here we are getting this error, main method is not found. So first happen when execute any code, the controller will find your JVM or compiler will find your main method. Okay, main method is there or not? JVM is not able to find the main method, that's why they have thrown this. So here what we are going to learn, why main method is required. Okay, so main method is required. We have a multiple types of the method. If the end developer, which type of the method developer will different type of the developer, which type of the method will create, it is JVM is not able to recognize that method. So JVM people have developed one common method that is called main method. So main method is a common for all execution, means if you will start any code, it will search from main method is there or not. Okay, so why method is required for business logic or mathematical logic? Why main method is required, right? So 2 points I have discussed here. So here now we'll give this main method, okay, in this code. Okay, so now I have given this main method. Okay, so this method is called your user defined method, and now I have given this main method, and compiler and JVM will search here main method. Okay, so if I will compile this, now I am able to compile, I am able to execute, but you can see I am getting only hello. Okay, hello man, you can see, but I am not able to execute this user defined method. So when you will execute any class, then what happen, it will search main method is there or not. then it will execute this main method only. But we have a user defined method. Yeah, one more question. Yeah. Okay, that is fine. Okay. How to execute this user defined method? So if you are creating this user defined method, you must be called here. Okay, so we have to call this method. If you will not call this method, it won't be executed. But main method is automatically called by the JVM. Okay, main method, when you are executing this code, then main method is automatically called by the JVM. Then what happened? Class, okay, compile, then execute. Then compile, then compiler will, you know, search the main method. In main method, the control will come, and method is executing from sequential order from top to bottom. So when you will execute this code, it will search this main method. Main method is there, then control will go here, then method is executing in the sequential order from top to bottom, then it will execute your this, then control will come here, then this method call, then it will search where is your M1, then control will go to M1 and it will execute this. Okay, so like that, you know, here how it is going to work. So here what we have learned, how to start your Java coding. You have a JDK, then you have a one editor, then after that how to save this Java file. So we have an extension called dot java. Okay, so class name dot java extension. So this is your class, how to start your coding. So we have a keyword called class keyword, and if you are representing any real world object, okay, so by using this class keyword, this real world object will convert into the programming world. Okay, that's why we are using this class keyword. That class level, we cannot write the logic directly. If you want to write the logic directly, then what you have to do? If you will write the logic directly as a class level, then compiler will throw error. Okay, so why the compiler is throwing the error? Because as a class level, we cannot write the logic directly. There are two types of the logic. One is your business logic, one is your mathematical logic. So when you are developing any type of the logic, you have to create a method. So method here, two types I have just shown you. One is your user defined method. What do you meaning of user defined method? The method which is created by us, that is called user defined method. Main method, what is the main method? And this is called inbuilt method, developed by the JVM people. So main method is, you know, developed by the JVM developer. So when you create any class, it will search a main method. If why main method is required? So if so, JVM doesn't know which method you are going to create, right? User defined method means a static, non-static, return type or void type. So there is no communication with the JVM. JVM is not able to recognize that. So JVM developer have developed one common method, means that is called main method, where the execution is starting from the main method. Okay, so when main method is execute, then it will come. Okay, so after that, this control will go here. So how this method is working? From sequential order top to bottom. Okay, then control will come here and it will execute. Okay, so first it is execute, control will come here, it will search this main method. Inside this main method, it will execute from top to bottom, okay, in the sequential order. So it will execute, then it will, control will come into M1, then M1 will search as a class level M1 method is there or not. Okay, so that's why this output is coming. This is, you know, how to start your Java coding. Inside this we have many things. So what is some documentation I have given regarding this? So why Java? Java programming language mainly designed to develop the internet application by providing the platform independency, C and C++ programming. Java support developing only a standalone application. Okay, so it can only be executed in the current system, cannot be executed from remote system and network protocol. Actually, this C and C++, we are developing the, you know, a standalone application. What do you mean of a standalone application? The application which is using the single user, that is called a standalone application. C++, there is no remote, you know, cannot be executed from remote system via the network. I have used here, we have used the internet application providing the platform independency. What do you mean of this? You can see, you can take the example of Facebook. So we have a Facebook, we have a multiple users, right? This is called your internet application. Web application is called internet application. So for developing the web application, you know, Java is very, I mean, the most popular. Okay, so we have a also called independency. So there, you know, Java is platform independent. Means you can see Facebook user, millions users are there. They are using all the different platform. Okay, might be someone is using a smartphone, someone is using Linux, someone is using Mac, you know, Windows. So, but if you will develop the application on C and C++, like one application you develop on this window by using this C and C++, it won't be executing the different platform. So these are the disadvantage of this programming language. So this is, you know, advantage, you know, why Java came. So we have a types of the application. One is your standalone application, one is your internet application. So I already discussed what the meaning of a standalone means, single users. This notepad is your standalone application, right? If you will go in the, if we are using this, you know, Hangout, or we are using hello, you able to hear me, right?
Yes, sir.
Okay. So if you are using you know, any web application, like I'm using this Gmail, right? So multiple user we are able to use this, but we have a notepad. I single user can use. Okay, this is called a standalone application. Web application is called internet application. So definition of Java, Java is very simple, high level secured. Why it is called high level secured? Can see mostly company and mostly application are developed on the Java, all the banking application and e-commerce application, because we need a security. If it is not secure, then what happened? We lost the business, right? An object oriented programming language is developed by James Gosling in Sun Microsystem in 1990 for developing the internet application. Its first version released in January 23, 1996. So we have a Java features, simple, object oriented, secure, robust, portable, dynamic performance. Who developed the Java? I already discussed this terminology of in programming language. So we have a source code, right? So I when you are developing, when you have developed any application, when you are starting to develop this code and you did not compile and you did not execute, that code is called source code. Developer written the program, it written according to programming language syntax. So compile code means compiler generate program that is convert from source code. Okay, so you know that source, after compiling this, it convert into the source code. Okay, that, so what do you meaning of compiler? So what happened? It translate program that convert into the source code into the machine code, right? That's already I have shown you, right? Bytecode, that is called machine code also. Actually, we have one difference between compiler and interpreter. Okay, so interpreter will execute the line one by, you know, line by line, but compiler will compile the code at once. So this is the major difference between the interpreter and compiler. So it is also a translate the program, convert the source code into the machine, but line by line. Okay, what is the executable code? OS understandable code. Here I have written wrong. Okay, what do you meaning of executable code? Means executable code means OS is able to, you know, understand that code, you know, exe file, right? So this is called your executable code. Compilation means same thing, right? It process to translating source code into the compile code. Compile code means that source code is converted into the compiled code. Compile code means we have a bytecode, right? So it is a process for running compiled code into the get output. What is meaning of execution? So I think this all the steps we had followed here. Dot file, compiler, then dot class file will generate, JVM will interact by main method, then we are getting this output. Okay, so same theory just we have mentioned here. Java technology, Java is both platform and programming language. Platform is a hardware or software environment. What is meaning of the platform? We have hardware and software. In program are executed, Java has its own software based on the platform, is called JVM. Because when you are using your C and C++, there is no need to install any software. But if you want to develop your program in the Java, then we need a JDK. Or if you will install the JDK, then what happens? We have a JRE and JVM by default, right? So this is required. Okay, so execute Java program. Like C and C++ program, Java program are not directly executed by OS, but in the platform, so software and hardware is called platform. So just I have given this. So what is the meaning of platform dependent and independent? So I already discussed this. Platform dependent means if you will develop your software on the Linux, it won't be work in the Windows. This is called dependent. So C and C++ is platform dependent, but Java is platform independent. If you will develop my application on the any OS, or I can execute that that software in the any OS flavor, like Linux, Mac, and your Windows. Okay, so just this theory I have mentioned. Okay, I'll send you all this documentation, you can read once. Okay, so what are the Java files extension? So in Java we have a two files extension. We have a dot class dot Java extension file, it is called source code, which is developed by the developer, and we have a dot class extension file, it is called compiled code and contain bytecode, which is generated by the compiler from source code. Like C and C++, Java, we don't have any executable file. Means if you will execute your code C and C++, we have a .exe file, but in the Java there is no .ext extension. Okay, so that thing I have mentioned here. Moreover, in Java, compiled code is not a machine code, instead a intermediate code. Means we have a bytecode and sort, new file and extension. What I have mentioned here, in C plus C and C++ application we have a exe file, but Java we don't have any exe file. So if you will save your file in the dot java file, then after executing this, after compiling this, we will generate, it will generate dot class file. This dot class having this bytecode, that thing I have mentioned. Okay, Java program developing compilation and execution procedure, this thing. Okay, how to develop your code, then execution, then output on your system. So that thing I have mentioned here clearly. Okay, so in Java program language, all the source code is first written in the plain text file. Plain text file means I am using this edit plus editor in the dot java class extension. Those source file are compiled into the dot class file by the compiler. Okay, file does not contain any code, means native to processor. So what happened? Native means this bytecode. Okay, so instead of contain the bytecode, native language of the Java virtual machine. Bytecode is native language for Java virtual machine. So JVM is able to understand only bytecode. The Java launcher tool that run your application, which instance of the Java virtual machine. Actually, your code, we are interacting with JVM, right? So So that JVM is only able to understand this bytecode. Okay, so types of the software, so we had already discussed this, right? Java software is divided into two types. One is your Java development kit and one is your Java runtime environment. I have shown you, right? When you are in JDK, this three software is inbuilt inside this JDK. We have a compiler, we have a JRE, we have a JVM. So this three software is already inbuilt inside this JDK. But what is the difference between this three software? We are going to discuss this. So we have a, what is the difference between JDK, JRE and JVM? So JVM is a subset of JRE and JRE is a subset of JDK. So when we install the JDK, JRE is already installed automatically. Okay, right, I already discussed. So JRE software is applicable as a separate package, so we can install JRE. No, if you have in your client want only execute, you know, only install the JRE. But what is the difference between JRE and JDK? In which environment you have to install the JDK and in which environment you have to install the JRE? Okay, in the real time. So when we have a development environment, when you have a development environment, okay, when you have a development environment, we need a JDK. Why we need a JDK? Because we have to compile the code and we have to execute the code. But JRE, only we are executing the code. Okay, there is no need to compilation. So in the production environment, okay, in the production environment, in the testing environment, we use JRE because we are only validating the application, executing the application. We are not developing the application, right? So in the production environment or in the testing environment, we install the JRE. In development environment, we need JDK in the real time. I'm telling about of real time. Okay, so JRE has only JVM. Hence, using JRE, we can only execute already developed application. Right? Application is only developed. Just we are going to execute or validate that application. Right? So environment in the real time project for developing. So we have a development environment. Here we need to install JDK. Testing environment, we need to install JRE only. Production environment, we need to install only what? JRE. Okay, so in which environment JDK is required? Development environment. In these two environment, only JRE is required because we don't have a, we are not developing the application and compiling the application. Just we are going to execute this application. Okay, so essential statement for the Java program to develop the compile, execute and print output. Okay, console. So we had already discussed this class block because only class allow used to define the method with logic. Main method because it's initial point of the class logic execution, and this is your system.out.println because in Java all kind of data is printed by using print statement. So these things already discussed in the details. Okay, so software required for developing the program, JDK. If you are starting your Java code, you need a JDK for compilation and execution. You need any editor software, like these are the editor software, right? This is your Notepad, Edit Plus, TextPad, you know, Eclipse and NetBeans. So you can follow this one, but I will how to install this, configure this tomorrow I will discuss you. Command prompt, by using this command prompt we can also execute our code. Each main method is mandatory for compilation or execution, only required for execution, not for compilation. We had already seen, right? If main method is not there, we are able to compile the code, but execution we must be required main method. If CLAD does not have a main method program, then compiler will throw this error. How to main method is executed by JVM automatically. Is it not because of a static keyword? Yes. Okay, main method is executed not because of a static keyword, because of it's called by the JVM software. when you are creating any user defined method, then they must be called, but JVM is calling main method automatically. This logic is already developed. When you will execute any class, then JVM will call this method automatically. Okay, so why JVM software has only main method? Why it is not execute user defined method, right? So I already discussed this, just I have given this. JVM execute only main method because it has main method calling a statement. It does not have user defined method calling a statement. Inside this JVM, they have already developed the logic. That logic is calling that method, but they don't have a user defined method statement. So that's why, you know, user defined method only if they are called from the main method, that's why it will execute. Why JVM software has only main method calling a statement? Why not user defined method? Or why method is initial point of class logic? So I already discussed all the things, just I have given this theory. Okay, right? So why method is required, why main method is required? Okay, if you have a user defined method, then how to execute this? So same thing, just I have mentioned same point. Okay, you can go through one this point. I already discussed this, and you can explore your just in the support here. So definition of main method. So main method is mediated between the Java developer and JVM to inform that, and the method should be execution, and just I have written the definition of the main method. The main method is a what? Inbuilt method. It is a mediator between the JVM and Java developer to inform that what are the methods should be execution when and which order, right? Because we have a multiple methods, right? This is a method, multiple method is there. Then how to execute this method? We cannot execute directly. All this method we have to call inside this main method. So same thing I have mentioned here. JVM to inform what are the methods should be execution and when and in which order. Okay. So these are your, just I have started for introduction of the Java. So just I'm going to stop your session. Tomorrow.